You know, I have more than 30 years doing this sport, you know, and I pass so much time repeating techniques, repeating kicks, even training on Christmas completely alone in front of a mirror or with a single friend, always trying for the perfect technique, trying for the perfect technique, looking for this. After, I continue to seek for perfection, you know, for the perfect movement. I'm 45, you know, I could not believe it. But still I'm trying to win. And still I'm ashamed when I lose, you know. And even when I saw a profi fighter, a young fighter, 22 years old, and I think, well, I can beat him. But really not. I always think I was a racehorse, you know. I was born for this. Sometimes as a trainer, I must join a fighter to a tournament, you know. And that is a tough world, you know, when they can knock you out. But it's exactly like going to climb the Everest, you know. If you like to climb, if you are a mountaineering, the higher the mountain, the higher your achievement. And it's exactly the same for a fighter. Your opponent is like the mountain for the guy that likes to climb. It's a challenge for you. And nobody wants to fight with an opponent that represents not a challenge. You know? If somebody wants this is not a real fighter, you know. A fighter always wants to fight with somebody that really is a challenge. If he was a good opponent, he did fair play, well, no, it's perfect. The bad feelings are going to be with you because you are going to think, why I didn't protect, why I didn't see this kick, why I didn't train a little bit more, you know. You will not be angry with your opponent, not at all, you know. In a sport fight, really, your opponent is your friend because without him, you will not be able to do what you like, and that is your sport.